is cut the wrong answers one by one, leaving the right answer remaining on the board. If you cut all three wrong answers, your team gets $300. I'll repeat the question. If you're in an Italian hotel, wanted to get off the elevator on the fifth floor, would you ask for the fifth cello, the fifth piano, the fifth credenza, or the fifth crescendo? Cut the wrong answer, Perry.
I'm going to cut credenza.
Let's see if we can. For Perry, let's cut the answer credenza. Ah, you're safe. All right, Mary, again, you got to cut a wrong answer.
Okay. I'm going to cut piano.
Let's see if we can. Perry just went, oh no.
Oh,
how about it? Can we cut the fifth piano up there? Bravo.
Isn't that... Time too, though, on the
That's
other
interesting,
game.
Isn't it? Remember? Piano in Italian means floor, among other definitions. Perry knew that, and
that.
He was ready to bop you one, but he didn't. That's all right. You did get rid of one wrong answer. We're going to give you $50 to start off with, seniors. And I'll tell you what we must do. We'll pause for these words. We'll be right back to give our juniors a chance to play Trivia Trap right after this.
Dinner time.
Welcome back to Trivia Trap. Our seniors had kind of a rough time on the first question. They do have $50. That's all right. Juniors are over here ready to play this game. Remember, it's the team that makes it to $1,000 that wins the game and goes on to play for a possible $10,000. Yeah. Puff, are you ready?
Yes, I am ready.
You've seen one row of answers. Riddler, Joker, Penguin, Mr. Freeze. Juniors on the top row. I have another group for you to consider. Dick Powell, Douglas Fairbanks Jr., Alfred Steele, and William Powell. Will it be the top or the bottom?
We're taking the bottom row, please.
The top is strictly a senior list, isn't it?
Not my list.
Good luck to you. On the premiere episode of Batman, who was the first villain to tangle with Batman? You know what you have to do.
Yes.
You have to start cutting the incorrect answers. There are three of them up there. If your team can do that, you get $300. So a wrong answer, please.
I'm going to cut the Penguin.
Fine, let's see. Hey. Hey. Can we cut the answer Penguin? Ah. You are successful. You're safe. Walt, find a wrong answer.
I'm going to cut the Riddler.
All right. Let's try it out. I don't know. The audience is going, ooh. How about it? Who's right? Walt or the audience? Cut the Riddler. The audience was right that time. Yeah, he was the first one. Frank Gorshin, by the way, played the part of the Riddler back in the first episode of Batman. Okay, you did cut one incorrect answer. We'll give you $50. The game is all tied up, and we go to Mary, who is ready to play. Mary, the top row, those movie stars. The bottom row, this group of answers. Airplanes, saddles, guns, and gavels. Top or bottom for the seniors, Mary?
Bottom.
The bottom. The question, President Reagan has metal sculptures all along the walls of his Oval Office. What are they replicas of? You've got to cut the incorrect answers.
Oh, okay, I'll cut guns.
Find out. For the seniors, cut the answer guns for me, please. You did good. That's right. Betty, two more wrong answers remain.
All right, I'll cut gavels.
Perry, you don't agree with that?
No, I do.
Oh,
I'm
okay.
Afraid I'm stuck.
Let's cut gavels if we can. We've never had a contestant that called the team members by names. I mean,
sorry about
you
that.
Stinkers, he said. Pressure's on you, isn't it?
It is indeed.
One more incorrect answer over there.
It's
worth $300. President Reagan has metal sculptures all along the walls of the Oval Office. What are they replicas of? Find the last incorrect answer, you get $300.
I'm going to guess and cut airplanes.
Cross your fingers, seniors. How about it for $300? Can we cut the answer airplanes? Yes! We got $300. There are 12 bronze saddles which depict the history of the Spanish riding from the 16th to the 19th century all along the walls of his office. And $300 for you now of $350. Walt, you can tie this game up, though, if you can be as successful as they were. Here we go. Juniors, you pick the answers now. On top, Dick Powell, Douglas Fairbanks Jr., Alfred Steele, and William Powell. On the bottom, juniors, this group. Joy of Sex, Sex and the Single Girl, Fear of Flying, and Stud.
Wait a minute.
You don't even have to choose. I've got it in my hand. Now, what will it be, top or bottom?
We'll try the bottom.
I knew you would. Helen Gurley Brown is the editor of Cosmopolitan. What book first made her famous? Find the wrong answers. All three will mean $300. You can tie the game. Walt, begin, please.
Bob, I'm going to cut Fear of Flying.
Let's eliminate fear of flying for our juniors.
Yeah.
You're safe. Hi, Kristin.
Hi.
Got a wrong answer for me.
Can you repeat the author's name?
Helen Gurley Brown, the editor of Cosmopolitan. What book first made her famous? You have to cut the incorrect answers.
Okay, I'm gonna cut The Joy of Sex.
Let's cut The Joy of Sex for the juniors. She didn't sound too confident about that. You know that, Puff. Now, Puff, two answers remain. One of those answers is wrong. If you can find it, you get $300. You'll be tied. Remember the question. Helen Gurley Brown, the editor of Cosmopolitan. What book first made her famous? Is the wrong answer Sex and the Single Girl or Stud? You must find the wrong answer.
I don't know why I'm going to do this, but I'm going to cut Sex and the Single Girl. No. Please. I changed my mind.
You can't. It's too late. Perry and the audience both go, oh. How about it? Cut Sex and the Single Girl. That was the trap you fell into. That was the correct answer, by the way. Okay, so you cut two of them, you get another $100 added to your score over here, juniors. You have $150, $350 for the seniors. That's the end of round one. That's going to be important to you, by the way. Okay, in a moment, we're going to be playing our $1,000 trivia race. Before we do that, though, let's take a look at those answers up there. Remember Dick Powell, Douglas Fairbanks Jr., Alfred Steele, and William Powell? Why don't we play with you at home? Let's play Trivia Trap. You ready? I'll ask you a question now. Joan Crawford was married several times. Who was her first husband? Joan Crawford's first husband. We'll be back in a moment with the answer to that question and also our trivia race in just a moment. Welcome back to Trivia Trap. How'd you do with our question? If you're an old movie fan, you remember now. Joan Crawford, first husband? If you said Douglas Fairbanks Jr., you were right. She married him in 1929. She later was married three other times after that, but it was Douglas Fairbanks Jr., first one. Okay, $150 for our juniors, $350 for our returning champions, the seniors, and now we're going to try for the goal of $1,000 as we play our $1,000 trivia race. Here we go. During our $1,000 trivia race, the winning team will then get a shot at $10,000. Seniors, you're out in front, so you get to start first. And in the trivia race, every question is worth $100. But let me tell you, after the 10th question, the value will then double. Each team will have three chances to come up with the correct answer. If all three of you miss, control then goes over to the other team. So seniors, good luck to you. Have $350, trying to get to $1,000. Perry, pick a category, TV, kid books, or detectives. Here we go.
Bob, we're going to try detectives.
Detectives. For $100, the race has begun. Good luck to you, and here it is. What is the nationality of Agatha Christie's fictional detective, Hercule Poirot?
Belgian.
You're right. He's Belgian. For $100, $450, trying to get to $1,000. Mary, the category.
Kids books.
Kids books. For $100, seniors, who wrote The Cat in the Hat?
Oh, it's Dr. Seuss.
Sure, Dr. Seuss. Ready, pick a category. You have $550,
$1,000. Which
one?
TV.
TV.
Top one.
Mm-hmm. Here we go. What new television series shows a U2 spy plane in the opening credits?
Trivia Trap.
No, sorry.
The one with the guy in airship? No.
No. Call to Glory. You're frozen at $550. Control now goes over to the juniors. You have some catching up to do. You have $150. Trying to get to $1,000. Puff, pick a category.
We'll pick songs.
Songs. Okay. For $100, in the song popularized by Peter, Paul, and Mary, who is the human friend of Puff the Magic Dragon?
Jackie Draper.
You gotta be kidding. I can't believe you got that question with a name like Puff. Walt, pick the category.
We'll take cities.
Cities. For $100, you have $250, trying to get to $1,000. What is the Vietnamese city of Saigon called today?
Hanoi?
Incorrect. Sorry. Kristin?
I have no idea.
Time's up. Puff?
Tokyo.
No. Incorrect. Ho Chi Minh City. You're frozen at $250. Control back to the seniors. Pick the category, Betty. You have $550, trying to get to $1,000.
Let's have TV games.
TV games. For $100, who was the original host of the original The Price is Right?
Bob Barker.
Incorrect. Sorry. Perry.
Bill Cullen.
That's right. Bill Cullen. You rescued your team. $650. Mary, the category.
Sitcoms.
sitcoms. For $100, seniors, on Leave It to Beaver, what is Beaver's first name?
It's Little Beaver.
Wally.
Sorry, Betty.
No, that's a Wally.
No, I'm sorry again.
Fred.
No. Theodore. Theodore.
Oh, Theodore Cleaver.
You're frozen at 650. Control, back to the juniors. Walt, pick the category.
Let's go with countries.
Countries. Countries. For $100, you have 250 trying to get to 1,000. What country has the most coastline?
United States?
Incorrect. Sorry, Puff.
Canada.
Canada. Correct answer. You rested your team. 350 trying to get to 1,000. Walt, the category.
MASH.
MASH. Yeah. For $100, juniors, what was the name of Colonel Potter's horse in MASH?
I don't know.
Kristin.
Sophie.
Sophie, yeah. Right answer. 450 heading for 1,000. Puff, the category.
Oh.
Hurry, please.
Original names.
Original names. For $100, what famous rock singer was born Robert Zimmerman?
Bobby Dylan.
Pardon me?
Bobby Dylan.
No, incorrect. Walt.
Bob Dylan. Dates.
Bob Dylan's the correct answer, yes. Okay, you have 550. You're trying to get to 1,000. I've asked 10 questions. Hereafter, all values double. Each question is now worth $200. Kristin, the category?
Foodstuffs.
Foodstuffs. Here it is. What kind of pudding is made from the Brazilian cassava root?
Yorkshire.
Incorrect. Sorry, Puff.
Tapioca.
Tapioca is the right answer. $750. Walt, you must choose a category.
I'll take yesterday's cast.
Yesterday's cast. Who played Nora Charles in the Thin Man movie series? Kristin.
Shirley MacLaine, I don't know.
Sorry, incorrect. Puff.
I can't think of her name. I can see her face.
Time is up. Myrna Loy.
Yes.
Myrna Loy. You're frozen at $750. $650 over here for the seniors. Remember, each question is worth $200. You're trying to get to 1,000. Mary?
Washington.
Washington. For $200. What was George Washington's political party?
Republican.
Wrong. Sorry. Betty?
Democrats.
Sorry. Again.
Federalists.
Perry again.
Federalists.
Federalists. Right answer. You rescued your team. Two more answers. All you need. Mary, pick the category.
Pick the category. Odd couple.
Odd couple. For $200, in The Odd Couple, Jack Klugman's wife played a role on the show. Who was his wife?
His wife was the maid. I have no
idea.
Mary.
No, incorrect. Perry.
Don't know, Bob.
Brett Summers. Brett Summers was the answer. You have 850. You're frozen right there. Back to the juniors we go. Second chance. Walt, remember they're worth $200. You need two more. Pick the category.
Rock hits.
Rock yes. hits. For $200, who sang the hit song Allentown?
Billy Joel.
Billy Joel. Yes, that's right. One more is all you need. Kristin, the category.
Babies.
Babies. For the game and a chance to play for $10,000, what is the name of Princess Di's newest baby? Puff.
Harry.
Harry's right, yes. And the juniors have won the race. $850.
Yay.
Not bad at all. I hope you had a good time.
We did,
you're wonderful.
Bob,
thank you very much for playing the game with us. Thank you. Juniors, you've done it. We'll be back in just a moment to give them a chance to play for $10,000. See you in a minute. Welcome back to Trivia Chat. Our juniors are new champions. Now they're ready to go for the big money. So we're time to play our $10,000 pot of gold. Are you ready, juniors? If you are, go over there and get in position. Look at that gentleman letting the ladies go first. How nice. Okay, up until now, you've played as partners, juniors, but now you're on your own. Each of you will be trying to win money for yourself. Your positions have been determined by your success in the trivia race. Puff, you have the first option to play or pass. If you're ready, let's go to the first rung of our trivia ladder, heading toward $10,000, and here we go. The answers are Leonard Starr, Chick Young, Chester Gould, Dale Missick. Now, Puff, you have the option. You can play or you can pass them on to Walt.
Walt, I love you dearly. You may have them.
You're passing them on. All right, Walt, you have the same situation. Because you're in the number two position, you can play for those answers or you can pass them on to Kristin. If you pass them on, she must
play. I'm sorry, Kristin. I'm really sorry. You got
it. Right
down
to Kristin they go. All right, it's your question now. You must select the correct answer. If you do, you win $1,000, a chance to play for $10,000. Kristin, here's the question. Who was the creator of the Dick Tracy comic strip? For $1,000 and a chance to play for $10,000, I need the correct answer, please. Who was the creator of the Dick Tracy comic strip. What is your answer?
I don't even know who these people are. Sorry.
Answer, please.
Dale Messick. I don't know.
Let's find out. $1,000 was Dale Messick, the creator of the Dick Tracy comic strip. No, I'm sorry. It was Chester Gould. Chester Gould.
It was between the two.
Kristin, we've got to say goodbye to you for today. You'll be back tomorrow to join your team to defend your trivia crown. So thank you very much, and we'll see
you
tomorrow.
Thank you.
All right, bye-bye. Puff and Walt, are you ready to go? As we climb to our next level of our trivia ladder, hang on, and here we go. The answers are Heart to Heart, Maud, Three's Company, All in the Family. Puff, okay. What do you want to do?
I'm going to take this one.
You want to take this one?
Yes.
All right, here's your question. What American TV series was based on the British series Till Death Us Do Part? Answer, please.
All in the Family.
You think it's All in the Family?
Yes.
For $1,000, a chance to play for $10,000. Is it All in the Family? Yes, it is. All right, Puck, you've got $1,000. You've assured your chance to play for the $10,000. So good luck to you now, Walt. Are you going to join her up on top? We'll find out right now. If you're ready, Walt, let's go to your level of our trivia ladder. And up there, we will find these answers. Dr. No, From Russia with Love, Goldfinger, Thunderball. You've got to play. Here's your question. What was the first James Bond movie?
Dr. No.
You say it's Dr. No. For $1,000, a chance to play for 10. Is it Dr. No? Yes! I think that's wonderful. You are so excited, Puff, for him, because he may take half your $10,000, but he may not. We're going to see.
All fair and loving, he's going to help me on the other side.
Well, that's great. Okay, good teamwork. Now, you ready? You each have a chance to play for the $10,000. Let's go to the final rung of our ladder, and here we go. Answers are The Star-Spangled Banner, Battle Hymn of the Republic, My Country Tis of Thee, God Save the King. The question, what famous patriotic song was originally called Defense of Fort McHenry? If you would, please, raise the covers in front of you and record your choice. What famous patriotic song was originally called Defense of Fort McHenry? Please lock in your answers. All right, answers have been locked in. Puff, what'd you say was the correct answer?
My Country Tis of Thee.
You say My Country Tis of Thee. Walt, what'd you say?
I took a wild guess. I said Battle Hymn of the Republic.
Battle Hymn of the Republic. All right, this is for $10,000. Is it My Country Tis of Thee? No, it is not. Sorry, it is not the correct answer. Well, Walt, it's up to you now. Walt, your answer was Battle Hymn of the Republic. If that is correct, you're going to win $10,000. Let's see. Is it Battle Hymn of the Republic? No, it is not. It was the Star-Spangled Banner. That means no one gets any of that $10,000 today, but you're going to come back tomorrow,
all right,
play again. Maybe you'll have a chance to do that. We'll be right back to tell you about tomorrow's show in just a moment. Defend their trivia crown. Hope to see you then. I'm Bob Eubanks. Bye-bye from Trivia Trap.
Looking forward to happy hour? With GSN's new 4-hour happy hour, you can get together with your friends.
I thought I overdressed.
Have some laughs. And check out the hotties.
That's it!
But watch out for the whammy. The 4-hour happy hour. 4 hours of your favorite game shows back-to-back. What better way to spend an afternoon? Weekdays starting at 3 on GSN. Cocktails not included.